Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 882, and today's topic is decoration and color of the ceramics. When we are saying decoration, it is actually glazing, and one is that is called under glazing and upper glazing. Glazing, you know, is the process of thin coating of ceramics by liquefied glasses, very thin coating. And underglazing means once in that glaze, if the color is mixed, it is called underglazing. And in case where the color is mixed with flux, and flux means it is a powdered form of rocky material, burnt bone, burnt rock, and in that color is mixed, that is called over glazing. And there are several methods of applying the color on ceramics to make it very, very beautiful and attractive. And ceramic industry is very much lucrative and attractive because of decorative pieces and very beautiful color painting. So the coloring is done either by painting or by grafting or by stamping or by painting and crafting. So there are different methods, so I will be discussing one by one. So here the decoration and application of colors in ceramic. Number one, decoration of ceramics. There are two types of decorations. Number one is called underglaze, and number two is called overglaze. Glaze means it is thin coating of liquid glass on the ceramic. In case of underglaze, the decoration, the colors and glaze are fused together. So once we are saying underglaze, means here the color and the glaze, that liquid glass material, they are fused together, the color itself, and that one is applied, that is called underglaze. While in overglaze, decoration are fused together with the help of soft flux. Soft flux means it can be flux of any rock, any like bone flux by burning and making it powder, that is called flux. So any flux can be used where the color is mixed, that is called over glazing. Number two, application of colors in ceramics. Colors to the ceramics are usually applied by the following methods. A, first, that is painting. Sometimes painting is done. B, stenciling is done. C, spraying. D, stamping with the help of rubber stamp, and then the color pad will be there, with that color pad stamp, and then go on putting, that is called stamping. E, printing, lithography, and F, that is silk screen printing. So these are all various methods are used to beautify, to decorate the ceramics in a very beautiful color. Graffito decoration is applied where precious metals such as gold, platinum and silver, etc. are used, are to be applied to the wear as an overglaze decoration. So this is very costly decoration. Overglaze decoration means these metallic precious metals, they are mixed with color and it is coated. And the gold decoration can be applied using an oil soluble gold compound or metallic gold powder. In stamping method of coloring, a rubber stamp made of rubber are used, and the stamps are charged with the color from a pad covered with the sticky color pigment. Number three, that is your silk screen printing in ceramics. In the case of silk screen printing of ceramics, it consists in rubbing or squeezing color through a pattern left free in material of very fine mesh. Silk screen on to the article to be colored. There are some very important points in ceramic industry. Those who are involved in that, they must remember and understand these chemicals and their importance. A. Clay, stone, cornish and sand are the main three raw materials used in the making of ceramic product. That is, in the beginning I have already told you, this main is, that is clay, we call it that is plastic, which can be moldable, and second is silica, silicate, and third one is minerals, rocks, they are mixed. B. The most important clay minerals which are used in the production of ceramic articles are as follows. One, that is colonite. The colonite is a type of rock whose formula is Al2O3, 2SiO2 and two molecules of water, 2H2O. The second is montmorillonite. In the case of montmorillonite, the formula is MgCaO, Al2O3, 5SiO2 and NH2 means water plus acid, maybe 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, any number. And third one is elite. Elite is your K2O2, MgO, L2O3, SiO2 with water crystallization. So these minerals, they are used in ceramic industry. Number four, from ceramic point of view, clays are plastic and moldable when wet and sufficiently pulverized, rigid when dry at high temperature. Number five, there are three common types of feldspars. Feldspars are very important and they are type of rock, and they can be sodium, they can be potassium, and they are known as feldspars, and these are as follows. A. Potash feldspar. The potash feldspar formula is K2O, Al2O3 and 6SiO2. B. Soda feldspar with sodium, that is Na2O, Al2O3 and 6SiO2. And third one is lime feldspar, that is with calcium, CaO, Al2O3, 6SiO2. So these feldspar are either potassium, sodium or calcium based. All these three are mainly used in ceramic industry and they play a very important role. So with this I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.